Hi, Dwyer. It's February, which means Valentine's Day. The coldest, but the hottest day of the month. Welcome to PD News, Episode 3.
Welcome back to PD News. This month, we will look at how Valentine's Day is celebrated here at Dwyer, all our Black History Month activities, and the role the Learning Common plays in student success.
Let's meet up with Owen and Nick as they explore all the Learning Commons has to offer.
Oh, hey, Nick. Where are you going? Isn't the calf that way?
I know. I'm headed to the library to print off my assignment.
Isn't the library closed during lunch?
Really? Not at all. The Learning Commons is almost always open, even after school. Here, let me show you.
Show me what exactly?
There are endless things you can do. Relax on the couches with a great book. Collaborate on your group projects at the table. Isolate yourself from the world while working independently. Print all your work at the printer for the small price of 10 cents a page. And even pretend to work when you're really playing on these fun entertainment chairs.
Wow, I didn't realize there was so much to do in the library. I think I'll be spending a lot more time in here.
That's great. Oh, I think it's called the Learning Commons.
Thanks, guys. Can't wait to get my hands on some of those white pine books.
And now we are joined by recording artist and motivational speaker, Sean Booth. Thanks for joining us today, Sean.
As you heard, my name is Sean Booth, and I am a hip-hop artist, where I tell the life stories of the world's greatest heroes, leaders, all through biographical rap. That's inside of each and every one of you.
What do you want students to take away from this presentation?
The biggest thing I would say is that, yes, as we celebrate all these icons like Malala to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. to Oprah, is I want us to really recognize that we have that same level of greatness and ability and power and strength inside of us no matter what our circumstances are. And we all can tap into that as long as we really tap into our own belief in ourselves and our faith in ourselves. There's something inside of us that is just as powerful. With youth, there's a lot less resistance, you know, and so there's a lot more hope there, a lot more openness. And to me, I just want to really just, you're already on the right track. I just want to just pour a little bit more fuel into your fire.
That's amazing, Sean. Thank you.
Thank you.
February has been a busy month here at Dwyer, but before we go, let's catch up with our man on the street, Ethan Norman, with his take on the fun side of Valentine's Day.
Wow, this Valentine's Day, we had so many spirit activities planned. From our pin game to our heartbreak fairy, I can really feel the love in this atmosphere.
L is for the way you look at me.
Hi, I'm here with Ryan.
Hi.
What were your techniques to get the girls?
I went to a lot of friends first, but then I got the idea. I was like, I'll sing if you give me your pins.
You sang.
I sang. I don't know.
Is even more than anyone that you adore.
I have 32.
Hi, I'm here with Emma, the other winner. What was your strategy to get the boys to give you the pins?
I complimented all of them and just like went up to them and asked them.
32 is a lot. Good job.
Well, I think it was just a really good activity for everyone to kind of hang out and get to know each other a little bit better and overall just get us in the spirit for Valentine's Day.
Love.
Well, Dwyer, that's all we got for this episode. Thank you so much for spreading your love this entire month of February. And that return, here's a chocolate.